How can time heal?
It's not right to bury your child.
These two men from different worlds.
I wanted to look like them. Rough, rugged, bad. In a whole different world than these walls.
This is their story of murder, revenge.
All I wanted was get this man that hurt my baby.
And a meeting years in the making. Yafeta Matalasi is a doting grandfather.
Good boys.
All my life is wrapped around them.
See if you can get up to where your brother is.
The younger one, he's got his dad's determination.
Nice. Very nice.
The older one has got his dad's brains in maths.
That's good, boys. Well done.
The missing link, their dad, Sio.
And he knew that he can play me. He knew that. He liked playing rugby. His love was NFL.
Sporty, cheeky, independent.
He contacted me on my grandson's birthday. And he said to me, Dad, come over.
August 22nd, 2013.
Next thing I know, the cops were at my door.
Two mongrel mob members, Shane Harrison and Dylan Parkai, pulled up at these Wellington flats armed with a sawn-off rifle.
And they were coming for a fight.
How did Sio get involved?
When he saw one of his friends being dealt to, he jumped in.
Joining a big brawl.
It was Shane who ordered Parkai to shoot. They were spraying bullets all over the place.
Then shooting Sio at close range.
Sio didn't make it to the hospital. He was actually the one that called the ambulance. And, he was, he knew he was going to die. He knew.
7 years later, this is the first time Yafeta has gotten this close to the spot Sio was killed.
I didn't go there when he needed me. I wouldn't want to go there.
Yafeta came face to face with Seal's killers in court.
My pleasure, Your Honour, Mr. Counsel, Solicitor, and Mr. Tenant for Mr. Parkai.
What were you thinking?
Do to him what he did to my son. And I'll do it with bare hands.
Through the trial, his anger burned.
I just see red. I just saw red.
How intense were those feelings?
Very, very intense. I saw Shane's son at the court. I thought, why do you have the right to have a father? And why does that guy have a right to have a son?
We've been given extraordinary access to go inside.
Thank you.
To talk to Shane Harrison.
There's so much I can say, want to say.
Why did you want to join the mongrel mob?
I wanted to be a mongrel mob because I wanted to look like them. Rough, rugged, bad.
Aged 50 now, but at 16, he was looking to fill a gap in his life.
It was a brotherhood, a friendship deeper than mum and dad's love, you say to see. Yeah. But there's an old saying, hey, you do the crime, you do the time. Hey.
After a three-week trial, Shane and Dylan were convicted of Seal's murder. And this enraged father was offered the chance to have his say. Writing his victim impact statement.
The more I cry, the angrier I got. And there was this voice. I knew it was Sio. He was telling me, Dad, nothing you can do can bring me back. Nothing.
On the day of sentencing, he stunned everyone.
without any reservations. Shane and Dylan, I forgive you. I plead with you to let Shane Pierre Harrison and Dylan Parkay go free.
He's now a deeply devout man.
He gives me compassion. He gives me the courage. Life can throw us any challenge, and the harder of a challenge, the stronger we get.
He's composed a song for Seal.
We are sinners, thou art our chainbreaker.
This means a lot to you, doesn't it?
It does. It does. This is my life now, and this is what has saved me.
They received Yafeta's forgiveness, but freedom was never an option. At sentencing, Dylan got 12 years, and Shane, who'd already done time for a violent manslaughter, got 13. Since the trial, Yafeta's wanted to meet them.
I just want to know what makes them tick as men. Why they have to be in a gang to be able to be a man.
How do you want to go and to meet Mr. Harrison?
I want to face him and tell him what I think.
Mike Hinton is an experienced restorative justice facilitator.
Why not provide opportunity for people to heal? Why not provide opportunity for people to listen?
How do you manage any risks involved?
Well, it's simply you need to engage with everybody beforehand.
And that can take years of persistence. Today, Mike's flown from Wellington to Hamilton to meet Shane's mum, Kahutoi.
We need to meet all people in the conference, and particularly support people such as Kahutoi.
What are you worried about?
It's important that the support people understand how the conference is conducted. Kia ora, mate.
Tēnā paita tūtaki I a koe.
Kia ora.
Nice to meet you.
And
in
you.
Person.
Come, let's have a seat, eh?
All right.
That's all right. My role as the facilitator is to ensure that we speak in a respectful manner.
Yes.
What happened to him? When did he go down a different path?
I believe in 85, when our baby died.
Yeah.
Things changed drastically.
So Shane would have been 15?
15 going, he was 14. Yeah, I struggled with taking care of my children at that time.
Yes, that was way back.
I didn't even see it coming. One day he was home, and the next thing he was telling me he's and the gangs. That was really hard. Really, really hard coping with that.
That family history will help Mike, who heads to Hawke's Bay Prison. Is Shane ready to face Yafeta?
I have a deep nervousness.
I'm
not one to scare easy, but you know, this is quite scary for me too.
And I think it could be challenging. What we're not going to do, there's no need to relitigate everything. It's finished.
Yep. All I can do is just be honest from my heart and respectful, keep the respect.
Yeah.
Shane is in the high security unit at this time. We're allowed in all the way to his cell.
This is an impressive wall, though. There's lots of important tangata out there.
We're sending my front lines and Te Ao Māori.
It's become really important to you.
It's always been. It's just when I chose the Mongol mob, I lost in touch with my pika, my te reo Māori.
He's been reconnecting, reflecting on his crimes.
When Mr. Matalasi forgave you, what did you think of that?
Honestly, I couldn't believe it. Actually, I didn't know how to think or how to feel wanting to meet Mr. Matalasi. And All I knew was that myself that I hate him.
Man to man, it doesn't matter how he puts up this face and all these tattoos, he's hiding. The real Shane Harrison is hiding behind the bravado.
Go! Come in! Come in! Ah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Matalasi's escape.
Ben, did you feel that oomph?
Is sport.
When Sio died, felt really sad. But then I thought, no. Get up. So I went and coached rugby.
Nice. Good work, boys.
Helping them out. It makes me feel good.
Same thing backwards. We go.
He was a Wellington High School teacher. But after Sio was shot dead, he just couldn't work anymore.
I'm still taking antidepressants. I've heard a lot of people say, oh, time will heal. How? How can time heal?
Time may not heal all wounds.
I think I'll use a 9.
But on the eve of his long-awaited meeting with one of the men convicted of his son's killing, Shane Harrison, it has brought perspective.
See, it still hurts.
Yeah.
But for me, I now see a pathway through my grandsons.
And an unexpected closeness with the man organising the hui, restorative justice facilitator Mike Hinton.
I've never hit a 9 off here. It's not just what we do for a paycheck. It's much more than that.
Had a chat with Shane.
All right.
I'm quite happy that he's in a good space to do the conference. Speak slowly, calmly, because everything you say,
yeah.
Shane, his mum,
yeah.
You know, they yeah. need time to process it.
Process it, yeah.
Now both men are ready for a meeting years in the making. Finally, this is the day.
Haere maira, haere maira.
Kia ora koutou, everybody. What we're going to do today is have a conversation. OK. Efita, it's been a long time. Please.
Shane, you're a son, I'm a son. You're a father, I'm a father. And nobody who is here can understand what I'm going through. Nobody. I was an angry man, Shane. My relatives, they were crying for blood. And I was just sitting there and looking at your family and looking at your son. This is honesty, Shane. All I wanted to do was revenge my son's death. But then I hold back and I came through. I'm prepared to listen to you.
Kia ora koutou.
Kia ora.
Every time there's so much things I would like to say and express, but there's things like apologies, sorries, can never bring back your son.
I know.
Bring back the peace that you're missing in your family's life now and your grandchildren. But from the bottom of my heart, I'm so thankful.
Thank you.
I'm so thankful.
Thank you.
From the whole of my heart, I'm so thankful for this blessing.
I believe you.
I've been one to not apologise, say sorry, because it was weak. But I'm saying sorry for what has happened to you and your family, Efita.
That's the most important thing.
The atmosphere is highly charged.
Just explain how you got to write that victim impact statement.
In which he forgave his son's killers.
Sio being Sio, I heard him. I actually hurt him. I'm gone. I've got sons. You've got to look after my son. What I said on that day stays.
I was shocked and I
come here.
I just couldn't believe my father would do that. Because at the time then, I wouldn't have been able to.
It's happened, brother. It's happened. Yeah.
I would want you to.
Good.
I would want revenge too.
For Shane's mum, Kahutoi, it's overwhelming.
I was just really, really heartbroken when I heard what had happened. And I was angry with my son. Yeah. Angry with the Mangumo. The forgiveness that you've given fills my heart too.
Yeah, thank you.
Sanetti is Yafeta's pastor.
I take my hat off for what he was doing. It was blowing me away.
In the same time, Shane, your journey's been really full of different challenges that you've accepted.
Because I was the older sibling, I was given a role, an adult role to be mum and dad.
Yeah.
And I started rebelling against him, which led me into a life of mischievousness.
Yeah.
Anti-social, anti-authority.
Yeah.
Because I liked the violence.
Yeah.
That the Mongol mob was all about. I'm not only apologising to you, to your family, and sorry, saying sorry, but to a lot of many other people that I've done wrong to.
Ka pai. Ka pai, mozo. Ka pai. Thank you.
They talk for over an hour and a half about the past and the future.
If you ask me now, I would like to see him out now.
As much as you would like me out, I'm not ready to get out. I need to do all this, what I'm doing.
Okay. Yep.
I need to go through this this journey, what I'm doing now, and this change, change is a must.
Right. That's good. Once you're out, you're going to come to church with me.
Oh, that could be a big challenge for me.
It needs to be mana enhancing, where people, we're humans, we're not just a name on a page on a summary of facts. If we're going to heal ourselves as a society, it's more than just the offender must be locked up and thrown away the key. Restorative justice provides that opportunity to change.
Before returning to his cell, a few precious moments.
I've got some gifts for you, your fetter, for you and your family. I made this all myself.
Well, thank you.
Family from my heart. And once again, I'm so sorry.
So how did that go for you?
That was real. That was absolutely, for me, mind-blowing.
For me, it was quite overwhelming.
What kind of life do you want?
A better and more respectful and honest living with my children, my family, and hopefully I can persuade them to not go down the path that I've set. Yeah.
Shane's still got work to do. For your fetter, it's all been worth it.
How will you walk out of here?
I'm a happy man now. Very happy.